Airman Cave Archives. Knowing and doing are two different things. Welcome back to Airman Cave Archives. So tonight, what we're going to do is go over a story of two hats. First off, we've got the one I'm wearing right now, and this is actually pretty cool. It's autographed by Red Holland. And I actually got to meet him. If you guys don't know who Red Holland is, he was from Outdoors with Red or Gone Fishing with Red. And it was pretty neat. He had a show, I think it was on PBS or the local channel. Where he would do his fishing escapades or hunting escapades. Well, I got to meet him at the Wiregrass Commons whenever I was a kid. And I got the hat signed for my grandfather, Grandpa Jim. Now, keep in mind, the reason I had it signed for Grandpa Jim was because he was a huge fisherman, and he loved to fish all the time and go out to Lake Okeechobee and things like that. Kind of funny story along those lines is whenever I'd gone out fishing with him one time, we stopped off to pick up his friend and his friend's son. Well, the biggest thing was every time that we would go out fishing, it was every time you caught a fish, you got a dollar for us kids anyway. So we got done fishing and I think I'd caught like 11 or 12, something like that. And my grandpa's buddy's kid only caught maybe two or three fish. So we got back to the dock and we started cleaning up and everything. And I went to go to the bathroom after we gotten done with the fish to wash up. And I had the kid come along with me. Keep in mind, I was a kid too at the time. I was probably about 12 or 13. So we go to the bathroom, and on the way, there's a trash can. And on the top of the trash can, there's a $50 bill. And the kid pulls it out, and he pops it, and he goes, "Dude, look, I found a $50 bill." I said, "Let me see that." So I took it, and I looked at it. In my hand, I was like, "Yeah, that's a $50 bill." But I balled it up and threw it on top of the trash can. I said, "Dude, you can't tell the difference between real money and fake. That's a fake one." And rushed in, you know, go to the bathroom and wash my hands really quick. And I came back out and I grabbed it up and put it in my pocket. Now, whenever we got done, we went back to the car with my grandpa and everything and his friend, and we headed home. So we get back to my grandfather's friend's house and we're dropping them off and we start divvying out the money and my grandpa gives me my cut. And then we start giving the other kid his cut. And I told my grandpa, I said, "Hey, grandpa, would it be okay if we split up the money so that we have the same amount or just, you know, about that?" He's like, "Yeah, that's cool, man. Okay." And my grandpa's friend was like, "Wow, you've got a really good grandson. That's kind of, you know, nice of him to do that." So we leave. And then when we're driving back to my grandfather's house, I pulled out a $50 bill and pop it. And he's like, "Where'd you get that?" I said, "Funny story, Grandpa." So I told him what happened and everything. He goes, "Okay." He's like, "Now that's my grandson." And it wasn't that. Yeah, okay. So it was probably, it was bad. But it was just, I was quick thinking. And basically it netted me a couple more bucks than I probably should have had in my pocket at that time. But that is not a fish story, although, yeah, I've had quite a few of them since being retired and being able to catch some fish of my own. So it just happens to not be $50 bills. All right. So with the Red Holland hat out of the way, let's take a look at a different hat from a different time in my life. Now, this hat is actually a Dr. Seuss hat. This was my mortarboard from whenever I graduated high school at Carroll High. The cool thing about this one was I had actually had the opportunity to paint my hat with Dr. Seuss on it. I had originally tried to wear my top hat with the mortarboard on it, and they had told me, hey, if you do that, you're going to be booted from graduation and you won't be able to attend. And so I was kind of upset, and I thought about, okay, well, my workaround is to be able to put Dr. Seuss on the hat instead of actually having the big top hat at the graduation. Well, to say the least, I was kind of bummed out that I didn't get to wear the top hat, but I figured, hey, it's a good sell to be able to go and just do the cat in the hat on the hat. Well, I get to the graduation, and one of the vice principals, after we had lined up, is standing there, and he comes by and he grabs my hat. And he takes it off. And I was like, what in the world, man? And so I'm sitting there running around trying to find this guy, and eventually I do, but he's handed off my mortarboard and actually given it to one of the other teachers, and now he has a blank one. And of course, it was like, what? No, dude. I sat there and I painted that one so that I could have that at the graduation. This is, you know, a crap. You know, I really want that back. And he said, well, sorry, bud, you know, you can't have it. Well, now I'm kind of at a, you know, loss, because if I waste any more time, I'm going to miss actually be able to walk in and do the graduation and walk the stage. So I go ahead and I take the mortarboard that he gives me. Obviously, it's too small for my head because they hadn't measured it, and it's not mine. And I go and I sit down, and, you know, so I'm sitting here through the graduation with a mortarboard on, no Dr. Seuss. And it's too small. I'm sitting there getting ready to pop off my head. And, yeah, to say the least, I was very bummed out that I was not able to have my Dr. Seuss mortarboard with me whenever I graduated. So now that you know the story behind Red Holland's ball cap that I gave Grandpa, and the Dr. Seuss mortarboard that I did not get to wear to graduation, but I still am proud to have taken the time to be able to paint on it, hopefully you can go out there and do something to have a couple stories to go behind some hats that you fit on your noggin, and yeah, make it through the course of the day. But thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Airman Cave Archives!
Knowing and doing are two different things.